Let's start with an easy one. What's the status of Reed Baker Whiting?
Hamstring strain. Probably not the first Dallas game. Maybe not even the second, might be a push. But if we need him, maybe for the third, he might be back.
And just to follow up on that, he had a pretty big reaction. Did you get the sense that was more of him worried about the injury or more frustrated that he was coming out of the game?
I think a little of both. The kid's never been injured. I remember Josh Dente when he got his first injury. They're the same. They're young. It's emotional. They don't really know, okay, how bad is it? So he was, feeling that he had a good game, and then he had to come out.
Nico says that the door is closed. This is definitely it for him in Seattle. How have you had conversations with him to know that he feels that way, and how do you kind of react to that?
Oh, it's sad. He's been such a great player for the club, but, he's the one actually that, makes the final decision. So, we're going to enjoy him for as long as we can, Jada. And, it's his choice.
Nico basically said that he felt like you guys doubted him and didn't really express the desire to bring him back from coach staff all the way up to the front office. What would you say to him?
Well, that's his opinion. I would say that this club has done a good job of, making sure the players feel welcome, and certainly Nico's achievements on the field, have been great. I think the coaching staff does a good job. I think Nico's been supported. We've had good players here. Sometimes it just comes down to business. Like we all know, people can get emotional. Reed, Chad Marshall, when he retired, other people. Nico's an emotional guy. You saw him, on that last home game. You could see it. So how he feels, we respect how he feels. So, again, it's maybe to your question, maybe it's a little sad, but, we've got to respect his feelings.
Do you feel like you could have done anything different in terms of dealing with him throughout the year to show him that he was welcome here, you wanted him in the future?
Well, I think we did that. I think we showed him that we wanted him here, but maybe not to the level that he expected or wanted. But we certainly made it known that he's been a great player. We'd like him around. But, at the end of the day, it comes back to his choice again.
So looking ahead to Monday, when you come off the field and you see that it is going to be Dallas, what's your first reaction to facing FC Dallas here in the playoffs first round?
Tough team. A couple of draws. 9 games unbeaten, if I'm saying that correctly, but only 2 wins and 7 draws, I think, Kevin.
Yes.
So look, you can it's statistics, you can twist them around. They're undefeated in 9, and it sounds really good, but they've only won 2. So how does that relate to us? We kind of set that same narrative out there. We're undefeated, but, how many wins have we actually had? So good team. Good, young, strong team. We'll be ready for them.
When you, I know it's your job to make the lineups and make those tough decisions, but when you have players like Nico and Raul that you aren't, putting in that in that starting lineup, mm-hmm. How challenging maybe is that, given the talent that they have and the production that they can still give, or how has that been?
That's a great question, Jada. Look, I'll start with Raul. So Raul in the Charlotte game came off the bench. Started that game, scored a couple of great goals. We thought he had him back, and then another little niggly injury here, Jordan coming on. It's just conversations. It's conversations with Raul. Look, this is the team I'm going to go with. And then both Raul and Nico, to their credit, because they're good pros, they know what's going on, their commitment is to the guys in the locker room. They say, yeah, I'm upset. I want to play. They let me know they want to play. But then they say, but we'll be ready. If you need us, we'll be ready.
Do you think Nico can still contribute at a starting level anywhere else on anybody else's team?
Sure. He might still be a starter on this team. I just happened to select a different team the last game. But the game before that, last game against Vancouver. So we'll see.
Are you adapting your preparation differently because of the clear change of format on this playoffs?
We'll practice more penalty kicks. We got a pretty good penalty kick taking team. You've got Raul, Nico, Montero, JP, Albert. We got a great goalkeeper. A.B. Sissoko.
Yeah,
A.B. Sissoko. You might see him on the bench. We got a good penalty kick taking team.
What's the situation with Kellen Rowe?
Kellen Rowe? He's back in full health. I mean, he hasn't seen the field a lot because, you know, Reed's, you know, development has kind of pushed some of, you know, Kellen's minutes. But we had a conversation out there just today. Funny how you saw that. Maybe that's the question. He wants to play. He's another veteran guy that we'll rely on and we'll need. So gotta keep him ready.
That kind of leads to it. It's just that without having Reed, that you can't go back to calling on Kellen.
Oh yeah, yeah. And then, you know, the way this schedule is, why that's relevant is because, you know, knew who's gonna go away again in the next window. And, you know, the games are so far apart, you know, we'll need everybody.
Going back to Saturday, I know last week that you said you would be aware of what was happening around the Western Conference there. So were you keeping up to date close on what was happening in LAFC Vancouver?
Because of our scoreline, 2-0, you know, obviously we're coaching the game. You know, the penalty that they almost had that was rightly VAR'd. Gave us some time on the bench to kind of look at scores and what did we need to do, what was our substitution patterns. Yeah, we were paying attention.
When you are assessing the potential distraction versus the, I don't know, maybe even the potential weightlifting of Nico making an announcement like he did, where do you fall in terms of that?
I take it as it's a good thing. I know it was kind of, look, the players, they all talk in there, and they all kind of knew where Nico stood. For it to come out now and let's just move on. Nico's again, like Craig said, Mount Rushmore, top players of our club. The club will do something good for him, I know. Let's focus on the now. Let's make sure that we're ready and we send him off in the right fashion.
It's not typical for soccer clubs to retire numbers. I was, you know, how other sports do it. Would you like to see eventually?
We could ask Alex. That's
a great question, Jess.
I mean,
great question.
I mean, we don't have anything like that, so maybe we need to
50th anniversary season coming up.
Yeah.
Is this an odd way, though, for a player that's given so much to the club to make his exit?
I don't know if anything's odd these days. Jada, I mean, look. Nowadays, social media, athletes, everything, kids, I mean, it's out there, those stories. It's not just soccer, it's in baseball, basketball. I mean, some of the trade rumors in basketball these days, and who wants to leave, who wants to stay. I mean, I think it's just part and parcel of the new times.
Wanted to ask a question about Jackson. How have you seen him grow this year, and how do you hope he will impact the team during playoffs?
Well, he'll impact the team in the playoffs the way he's done it all year. He's been very good, very steady. His improvement, yeah, Wade Weber, he saw it. I think Andy Rose has done a good job with him. So, it's good. It's what we needed.
Steph made a similar comment, you know, as far as, you know, his future here, yeah. Leaving it in doubt. How do you feel about that? Or
well, another Mount there. Rushmore. I mean, we could have a separate Mount Rushmore for goalkeepers. you could do that, Jada. But no, again, certainly there's conversations ongoing there, and you know, we'll see where the two sides come. He's again a leader in that clubhouse, and I know that Stephen Fry is focused on Dallas and making sure that we continue this season.
Thank you.